Cardinals first and 10 at their own 15. Steve Pisarkiewicz has 2 for 8 in the air for a total of 8 yards. Anderson has carried 17 times for 74 yards for the Cardinals. Wayne Morris is the other setback. That's Anderson carrying. Slipped on the cut and was brought down at the 16th, gain of a yard.
A little daylight in front of him, too.
It'll be second down and about 9.5 yards to go.
Well, Washington, Green Bay hanging in there. 10 points now in fourth quarter.
Anderson has carried the ball more than any other back in Cardinal history in the course of the season. He has exceeded the 269 carries by Jim Otis in 1975. Sarkis faked the draw, throws a screen left. Morris has the ball. Wayne Morris gets across the 20 to the 21, perhaps.
Let's take a look. Screen left. We'll see 28 Charles Cornelius come up, spin him around. Here's Morris. Waiting for the guard and the tackle to move, and the tackle's going on with the block. Here's your guard, Bob Young, out in front. Morris catches it. 28 right here, Cornelius. The left arm spins him around, and the pursuit does the rest.
Third down and 5 yards to go. Cardinals ball just across the 20. Sarkowitz is quarterback throughout. Sarkowitz. Complete. Mel Gray, he's a speedster, 30, 35, 40. So it's a first and 10 for the St. Louis Cardinals. Willie Harper, the linebacker who made the tackle, is at the 42-yard line.
Longest pass play of the day for St. Louis, 22 yards to Mel Gray. We watch Bill Walsh on the sidelines.
Seven minutes, 20 seconds left in the third quarter. 49ers deploy their defenses. The Cardinals come up, doubling receivers to the right side, Tilly and Gray. Morris and Anderson in the I formation for Pisarkiewicz. Pisarkiewicz has the ball. This one is also completed.
Tilly.
That Tilly goes to the 43-yard line of the San Francisco 49ers.
Both teams moving the football better here in the second half. Pisarkiewicz looks 100% better. This time, Tilly just a little hook pattern, wide open on the little hook in the middle of that zone. First down.
Cardinals are leading by a score of 7-3. Gain of 15 yards on that pass play. Again, it's Gray and Tilly right. Tilly's in the slot.
They're not even using a tight end now. They've got the three wide receivers in their room.
This is Anderson. Gets nothing. It'll be second and 10. Willie Harper again on the tackle for the 49ers. Washington 38, Green Bay 21 in the fourth quarter.
It's all over. Washington hanging right in there. They'll move their record to 9-5 on the year.
Second down, 10 yards to go. On the draw play, it's Anderson. 40. 35 and out of bounds at the 34-yard line. That's the first and 10.
Well, did you see him put that right shoulder in there and give that guy a shot?
Well, maybe it's not a first and 10. Hold it. Gray and McIntyre on the tackle. No, it's not enough. And they align it now and spot it at the inbounds marker.
And here's one final we got for you. Cleveland beat the Oilers 14-7. Boy, that Oilers now 10-4 on the year.
Willard Harrell is coming to the ball game, and Anderson has come out on a third and short. Harrell's the tailback. Morris is the fullback. Harrell did not get to the line of scrimmage. It was Tim Gray who came in to make the tackle. Fourth down coming up, and the crowd says go for it.
And Pittsburgh wins its 11th game of the year. The record now 11-3. They take a game lead over Houston.
Fourth down, about 2.5 yards to go. Cardinals are leading by a score of 7-3. 5 minutes to play in the third quarter, and they're going to go for it. Larry Wilson, coach here today.
He punted in the first half on the 31-yard line.
This is Harrell. He's got the first down.
And then so.
First and 10. Outside the 20-yard line.
Good blocking. Harrell picks up 15 around the right side. It is again. Watch the inside handoff. There goes Young again pulling. Archie Reese made penetration. Didn't get the tackle. Good hole over there. Finally pulled down. 76, Dwayne Board from the offside.
A double, Gray and Tilly to the right side. Harrell on the right set. Harrell. Fumble. And the Cards retain possession. Wayne Morris on the ball.
Good heads up play by Morris. That was a loose football. Here it is, the same play that Harrell just picked up 15 yards on, only to the opposite side. That's Terry Steve, the guard, pulling. Dwayne Board at good penetration. 59 is Willie Harper. Now the ball comes loose. 74, Jimmy Webb. I think his big paw knocked it backwards, and Wayne Morris gets it back for St. Louis.
Loss of five, and Anderson has come back in now. Otis Anderson's back in there. Harrell has come out. Second and 15 at the 25. Tilly in motion across. Pisarkiewicz.
Blitz.
That's all. Dropped him outside the 30-yard line.
Somebody didn't pick it up, Lindsay. Most teams in the National Football League have an automatic when they see that blitz coming. Just an automatic pattern. Nobody picked it up in time.
It's at the 31-yard line. Third and 21. Charles Johnson in defensively now for the 49ers. Tim Gray has gone out. Pisarkiewicz. Complete. Not nearly enough for the first down. Pat Tilly made the reception. McIntyre made the tackle.
Tilly small, 5'10", 171 pounds, just on a little hook pattern. Got him in field goal range.
Picked up 10 yards on it. It's fourth and 11, and so now they're going to go for a 37-yard field goal. Steve Little is in to attempt.
7 out of 13 on the year.
Roger Worley's holding for him. Whistle stops play. Whistle before the snap. Penalty marker, of course.
Start. Number 65.
Brad Oates. Brad Oates of the Cardinals. Number 65.
The Bears beat Tampa Bay 14-7 to pull one within one game of the Bucs in the Central Division of the NFC. Tampa Bay now 9-5, the Bears 8-6, and still alive. Tampa Bay plays the 49ers next week in San Francisco.
Like both offenses, the microphone of the referee is sputtering here this afternoon as the penalty has moved the ball back to the 25-yard line. Still fourth down, of course. A Paul, for two straight weeks, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers have gone into games knowing that if they could win, they were in the playoffs.
And they win one out of the last two, they've been in the playoffs.
And now they're only one game ahead of the Chicago Bears, and they come to San Francisco to play the 49ers next week, and we'll be there.
We'll be there, and you'll see a young football team, you 49er fans out there.
The clock was erroneously not stopped. There should be 1 minute, 45 seconds.
All right.
That's an explanation. The clock says
it's still running.
It started again. Are they going to try to run it down and correct it? Should say 1:45, says the referee. He's as interested as we are.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's just like we are up here wondering what they're going to do. Going to run it all the way down?
When we get to 45, we'll know something. So it's down to 45. Now they've changed to one.
All right, we're going to get it.
A runaway errant clock. It's been that kind of day here in St. Louis, and the crowd gives a roar, the biggest roar of the day, for the clock correction. Fourth down, and now it's going to be a 42-yard field goal attempt by Steve Little with Roger Worley holding. 42-yarder. And it is no good.
No good. Wide to the right.
Ball goes over at the line of scrimmage. Since it is outside the 20. And the St. Louis Cardinals are still leading in this ball game by a score of 7-3. As the 49ers will get it at their own 25-yard line.
After all these years, I still like working out. But what I really like is the beer that's waiting for me when it's over. And if you work out the way we do, there better be a lot of beer waiting. That's why we drink light beer from Miller. Light has one-third less calories than regular beer, and it's less filling, and it tastes great. Take it from a guy who works out a lot. Could really use one right now.
There you go, Bruce.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Melvin Stark, CPA, is about to break free. In Ford Mustang, a sports car for the 80s. Mustang performs and handles like a sports car.
At least a wild card berth with that win today over the Lions.
First and 10 now for the 49ers. Steve DeBerg, the quarterback. DeBerg has the football. Clark makes the diving catch. It is complete across the 35-yard line. Carl Allen on that corner. And that's a first and 10 for the 49ers.
Now, DeBerg, of course, been playing all year. Just see the difference in the rhythm and the passing. He knows he's been in there. There's another final. Washington by 17 over the Pack.
Double wing alignment. Hofer in motion across. Steve DeBerg swings it out, incomplete. Forward pass behind the line to Farrell. Pressure put on by Mike Dawson. Second and 10, 49ers at their 35. St. Louis Cardinals coached today by Larry Wilson. Bud Wilkinson, of course, on Wednesday dismissed. Wilkinson lost more games in his 15 months with the Cardinals than he did in his first 14 years at the University of Oklahoma. 14 years at Oklahoma, he lost 19. 15 months with the Cards, he lost 20.
Well, if you know Bud, you've got to love him. Great, great man. Well respected.
Farrell carried. Out to the 37-yard line for two. Mike Dawson in to make the tackle. It is third down and 8 yards to go.
And Jim Hart told me he respects him. You know, Jim Hart, of course, we talked about it in the pregame, that in a very precarious situation. If he becomes a free agent and he signs with another team, it's not too much of a possibility of that, Lindsay, because of the collective bargaining agreement, the team that would sign him as a free agent have to give up two first-round draft choices, and I don't think that's going to happen. So his only shot is to get traded, I think.
DeBerg swings it out to Farrell again. And Farrell gets up to the 40-yard line. Airfield made the tackle. That brings the punting unit out now on a fourth and five for the 49ers. There is an injury delay now as a Cardinal player is down. John Bearfield.
Shaken up a little bit in the first half, came back. He's been banged up pretty good with injuries all year long, only to come back all year long also. Here's a little screen pass in the right side with play action here. There goes your first back trying to take care of the linebacker. Just a running little screen here to Farrell. Needed a lot more yards here. Now watch him put his head down. And boy, he banged right into Johnny Bearfield. There he is, 58, right on his back.
Clock is stopped with, well, it's running again now, and time has run out before they can snap it. So time has run out in the period. And that's the end of the third quarter with a score, the Cardinals 7 and the San Francisco 49ers 3. We now pause for a word from your local station.
Tonight, Gonzo fights to save a derelict's life while Trapper John tries to save Gonzo's career on Trapper John MD tonight.
This is CBS.
The most famous reindeer of all, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, lights Santa's way to Christmas. Next, the Johnny Cash Christmas with June Carter Cash, Tom T. Hall, Ann Murray, and comedian Andy Kaufman. Then a tribute to Ingrid Bergman with Cary Grant, Goldie Hawn, Frank Sinatra, and Jimmy Stewart. A special Thursday starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
As we start the fourth quarter here in St. Louis, it's the Cardinals 7 and the 49ers 3. Fourth down situation, fourth and five, has brought the punting unit on for the San Francisco 49ers. Dan Melville into the punting. Roy Green and Willard Harrell have dropped back to field it for the Cardinals. The report on Freddie Solomon is that he is out with a sprained ankle and will not return. Now Melville. Bobble the snap. Tries to get to the sticks. Does not. The ball goes over on downs to the Cardinals at the 39-yard line. That's Sean Clancy made the tackle.
Sean Clancy, second-year veteran, makes the tackle here. Here's a bobble by Dan Melville here on the snap. It's right there. It's a good snap. A little bit high, but he should have had it. Just exactly where you want the football, and Melville tries to get around. Just a decision there, Lindsay. I think he didn't have that much pressure put on him. They weren't trying to block the punt. He could have picked it up, I think, and got the kick away.
Been that kind of a year for Coach Bill Walsh. First and 10. It's near the 38-yard line. Pisarkiewicz. And he's dropped at the 40-yard line. Archie Reese got to him. It'll be second and 12 now for the Cardinals.
There's Pisarkiewicz, just play action. Back. There's Archie Reese, 78, and 75, Ted Vincent is going down. The ball was popped free. And this year, the new rule is they will really call the whistle fast when those quarterbacks are in their grasp of the defensive lineman.
Anderson changed speed and moves inside the 30. Tim Gray.
He's got some speeds, boy. He can change it.
First down.
Seems like every time they give it to him, it's 9 or 10 yards. 14 yards on this spurt.
Ball is spotted at the 27-yard line. Pisarkiewicz has quarterback the St. Louis Cardinals throughout the ball game. Jim Hart has seen no action. Kelly on the slot right. Steve's in the wide left. Anderson.
Fumble.
Fumble the ball. Scramble is on, and the 49ers get it. San Francisco gets the ball. First and 10.
Well, Anderson's closing in on 100 yards. Off the left side, coughs up the football. Let's take a look at Danny Bunce here. I think he gets it back right there. Willie Harper is there. Danny Bunce comes over the top, and Bunce, the middle linebacker, has got it for the 49ers.
Well, the 49ers take over first and 10 just in advance of their own 28-yard line, and they are trailing by 4 points in the game.
Now, the best zenith ever, System 3, is even better.
Even better.
The sharpest zenith picture ever.
Sharpest picture.
An all-modular chassis designed to be the most reliable zenith ever.
Most reliable.
And now, better sound. Four speakers, audio jacks, even an audio control center.
Better sound.
Zenith System 3.
System 3.
Now, even better.
Look what's happened to home heating and air conditioning costs. Up and up. Up over 80% in 5 years. But there's a way you can fight back in your attic. Add another layer of pink Owens Corning fiberglass insulation. Ask your dealer or contractor how much more you need. Fight back against rising fuel costs. Get Owens Corning fiberglass insulation now. It's cheaper than oil.
Monday night on CBS, an all-star lineup leading off with the White Shadow, followed by MASH, WKRP in Cincinnati, and then Lou Grant. And it's all on CBS on Monday night. 49ers have the ball, first and 10 at the 28. DeBerg is 6 for 9 here in the second half, 57 yards. Joe Montana, quarterback in the first half for the 49ers. DeBerg. And Clark has it. Dwight Clark. Bobble it for a moment, advances it to the 42-yard line of the St. Louis Cardinals, first and 10 for the 49ers.
Clark on a little zig out, made the deep move. There's the final as we gave it to you, Philadelphia 44, Detroit 7. Picked up 32 yards on the little corner pattern to Dwight Clark.
We're in the fourth quarter. The Cardinals are leading in the game by a score of 7-3. Mike Schumann in a wide right.
Here it is again. Here's the corner pattern to Dwight Clark. Fumbled the football a little bit, but got it back. Hofer
carries inside the 35-yard line. Ken Green in to make the tackle.
Here's the final. The Jets beat Baltimore 30-17.
It'll be second down and 3 yards to go. At the 34-yard line, Clark in a wide left, Schumann in a wide right. DeBerg trying to hit Mike Schumann. Incomplete.
First quarter, Los Angeles blocked the kick. Joe Harris ran it 31 yards in for the score. The Rams lead the Vikings 7-0 first quarter.
Third down and 3 yards to go for the 49ers at the 34-yard line, and now a timeout. The 49ers take a timeout. DeBerg wants a consultation with his coach Bill Walsh and staff along the 49ers sideline. So the clock shows 12 minutes, 8 seconds remaining to be played in the game, and the Cardinals are still leading it by a score of 7-3.
What comes out of a loudspeaker is only as impressive as what goes into it. Pioneer's HPM speakers have a unique super tweeter that breathes to produce incredible highs. Its driver delivers remarkably crisp mid-range. Its bass you not only hear, but feel. So instead of sounding great on part of the music, HPM speakers sound great on all of it. Pioneer, we bring it back alive.
You're in the auto supply business? I'm in the auto supply business. You're in construction? I'm in construction. Chemicals? Me too. See, I'm really your branch office. Wherever your business travels take you, I'm already there. So, you can confirm appointments, handle orders, check on shipping, keep everybody happy. Excuse me. So remember, wherever you need a branch office, I'm your branch office. Use me.
Saturday and Sunday, December 8th and 9th, the battle for NFC playoff berths continues. When the champions are crowned, you'll say, "You saw it on CBS Sports."
Jim Hart warming his feet at the blower along the sideline. He spent a quiet day at the office. He has not been in action in this ball game. 49ers now 3rd and 3 at the 34-yard line of the St. Louis Cardinals. Big third down play coming. Hofer looking for 3 and driving. I don't think he got there.
He'll go for it. He didn't.
He did not make it. It's going to be 4th and I think about a yard, maybe less than a yard. They're going to bring out the chain.
Buffalo's tied it up against Denver, 16-16, fourth quarter.
They bring out the chain not only to measure, but to establish exactly how much is needed, and then possibly to use the chain to spot the ball at the inbounds marker. And it needs that much.
He just wanted a little bit more time. Now, they called for the measurement there. They knew they didn't have the first down. But it's their prerogative to call for a measurement with it's anywhere within a yard. And that gave DeBerg a little bit of time to go over and talk to Bill Walsh, see what he wanted.
Well, he wants the first down is what he wants. It's a fourth down play coming up. It's outside the 32-yard line.
Look at Jim Hart on the sidelines. Well, let's see. Hofer usually gets the call here, Lindsay, on that shirt, third and short.
Many times it's up and over.
But good spot here for play action spot pass.
Hofer, 1st and 10. Inside the 30-yard line. Kurt Allerman made the stop. But the 49ers keep the drive alive.
Watch Hofer. Boy, he really is a determined short yardage runner. All year long he's been doing this for the 49ers. First down.
Cardinals are leading 7-3. We're in the fourth quarter with the 49ers driving. Steve DeBerg. Hofer. Mark Arneson then on the tackle as he got near the 25.
Early surprise here. I don't know if it's a surprise or not. The New York Giants 7, Dallas nothing. Cowboys having a hard time. Billy Taylor scored from 2 yards out on a run.
2nd and 7 at the 26. Mike Schumann to the wide right. Farrell. Got near the 22-yard line. Eric Williams in to make the tackle. Third down play coming. 3rd and about 3. Outside the 22.
Third down. 4 yards to go.
Let's see if they go upstairs. They'll go for the first down here, I think. If they do run it, they've got two running plays left to make that 3 yards.
Hofer and Farrell, the setbacks. Hofer.
Close again.
Very close. He may have picked it up. If not, they've got one more down. But they'll take a long look here.
They got it.
1st and 10. Following the game, the San Francisco network will see Minnesota at Los Angeles, and the St. Louis network will see the New York Giants at Dallas. So stay tuned right where you are. Bill Francis is coming to the ball game now.
Let's say, Lindsay, another early surprise. Atlanta 7-0 over San Diego at San Diego.
1st and 10. 49ers at the 18-yard line. DeBerg. And it is completed down to the 5-yard line, taken by Francis, and Ken Green came in to make the tackle.
Francis did a good job of hanging on. He was pounded just as he caught the football. Mike Schumann was also open over the middle. You'll see Schumann come in motion here. Francis just slips through. Hofer in the right flat. They're just flooding the right flat. Good catch here, holding on to the football.
1st down and goal to go at the 6-yard line. 8 minutes, 37 seconds left to play in the game. Francis in the right set. Hofer in the left set for Steve DeBerg. Hofer inside the five-yard line.
Well, that's what he does so well. And he cuts back against that grain very quickly, and he gets a couple. Wasn't much blocking on that, but he still got a couple.
He did. It's near the three-yard line.
Get in for seven. They've also helped themselves out by taking a lot of time off that clock. DeBerg 8 out of 12 for 99 yards. Of course, he's had one touchdown pass called back.
Francis and Hofer are still the setbacks for DeBerg. DeBerg. McAfee, touchdown. Ken McAfee took it for the touchdown, and the 49ers are out in front in the ballgame.
Here it is, play action to the right. I think he slides past Roger Worley. Here's play action, just rolls a little bit to the right. Hofer helps out with the block on the linebacker. Good time for Steve DeBerg, and McAfee just comes back to the inside for six.
Conversion attempt coming now. Ray Wershing is in to try it. Montana will hold for him. Mike Dawson hobbled off the field for the Cards. Montana puts it down. Wershing boots it up, and it's blocked. I beg your pardon. It's through and good. Got by. So the conversion is good. And the score is 10-7. The 49ers out in front.
Introducing the 80 Ford Courier. Based on EPA estimates, it could be like money in the bank, because Courier is the gas mileage champ of the best-selling compact pickups. Yes, based on EPA estimates, Courier gets better gas mileage than any of the other bestsellers. Courier gets better gas mileage than Chevy Love, better than Datsun, better than Toyota. The tough Ford Courier. It could be like money in the bank.
You know, for too long now, bowlers have been left out of light beer commercials, and football players have been grabbing all the glory. But bowlers know light beer from Miller tastes great. We know light's got a third less calories than the regular beer. We know light's less filling. Bowlers love light just as much as football players.
That's right.
And we also love the easy opening can.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Sixty Minutes coming up on CBS tonight at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, when a black school teacher running for local office is charged with kidnapping on the eve of the election. And even the alleged victim says he didn't do it. Was it a frame-up? Watch 60 Minutes tonight on CBS. Wershing kicking off from the 35. Harrell is back deep along with Green. Green has it at the 3-yard line. He's out to the 5, to the 10, to the 15, to the 20. Green to the 25, to the 30. Stumbles up across the 35-yard line. The Cardinals start first and 10 at their own 36. 7.5 minutes remaining to be played in the game. Wright Hicks made the stop.
32-yard return. This is Thomas Seaver, the rookie, who really comes down normally pretty strong on special teams. He's made a lot of tackles for the 49ers. He's quick. He comes back, tries to get a piece of Green, but misses.
Steve Pisarkiewicz is still the quarterback. He has been all day for the St. Louis Cardinals. Thanks to Anderson. Pisarkiewicz throwing. And it's deflected, incomplete. Gerard Williams got a hand on it.
Good thing he did deflect it. It would have been complete.
Second and 10. Cardinals at their own 36.
Otis Anderson, 97 yards rushing today. Needs three more yards to have his eighth game of 100 yards or over. Looking at the rookie of the year right there, number 32, Otis Anderson.
The other setback is the Otis Brown. Now they're moving to an I formation. Richard Osmond looked over, and there is a flag and a whistle that stops play.
Too much time? If it is, you're going to hear some boos.
illegal formation, number 87.
That's 87, Richard Osmond, the tight end.
Made that last move. That cost them 5 yards.
Illegal formation, offense.
Second and 15. Back at the 31 now for the Cards, with the 49ers leading in the game by a score of 10-7. Sarkowitz, complete to Theotis Brown. He's at the 36-yard line. Got the 5 back. Third and 10. Jeff McIntyre on the tackle.
And it's just awful tough for a team, even though they only trail by 3 points, Lindsay. The performance today by the Cardinals has been anything but spectacular, to say the least. And it's just tough for a team to go through what they've had to go through this week and really be up for any game.
Pisarkowitz out into the flat. The Otis Brown goes out of bounds at the 46-yard line.
Should have put his weight back towards the field, Lindsay. They had a good head of steam going. Depends on where they mark it for the first down here.
It's not going to be a first down. It's going to lack a yard. Fourth down coming up.
It's going to be short. And they're going to go. They'll go for it.
Double tight end, Bill Morrell with Richard Osborne, both in there now. Wayne Morris coming in. Mel Gray's coming off the field. Fourth down and a yard to go. Ball is spotted at the 45-yard line of the Cardinals. Full house.
Two-man, it's Theotis Brown. They'd love to give it to the fullback here.
Theotis Brown's got the first and 10 yards to spare. He goes into 49er territory at the 47-yard line.
I think it surprised him that he got through that easily. Good blocking on the right side. Terry Steve, Joe Bostic.
First and 10 Cards now at the 47-yard line of the 49ers.
It's a little unusual for us to watch a Cardinal team without Dan Dierdorf, who I really feel maybe probably the best offensive tackle maybe to ever play this game. He went out early in the season with knee surgery.
Pisarkowitz. Diving catch by Tilly. At the 31-yard line, first and 10. Cornelius, the cornerback over there.
Well, they had to give him a little bit of room. Lindsay had him man-to-man over there. A final. Denver beats Buffalo by 3, 19-16.
It's the Cardinals who are driving now. They trail by 3 points in the ball game. We have 5.5 minutes left to play in this game. Killian Gray to the right side. Anderson changes pace. Spence through for another first down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Jeff McIntyre brought him down.
Well, he just shifts direction, shifts speed. There it is. 8 100-yard games now. It's a new NFL rookie record. And he's almost a cinch to break Earl Campbell's rushing record of last year, 1454 rookie. Here it is again. And Bob Young again, the guard, coming up, knocking the linebacker outside. That's Willie Harper, 59. And Anderson goes inside the block for the first down.
Anderson has shared the record of 700-yard games as a rookie with Franco Harris, Don Woods, and Earl Campbell, which is pretty fast company. First and 10 at the 18-yard line. Anderson.
Look at that.
Spins his way inside the 10-yard line. Wayne Boyd brought him down.
Makes you wonder why they don't give the football a little bit more to him. Even in a game like this, it's tight. Jeff McIntyre, 52, missed him. He just made that quick spin.
Second and 1 at the 9.
He might break Earl Campbell's record today if he's, they get the ball back. Minnesota, Los Angeles tied up first quarter.
49ers are leading by a score of 10-7, but the Cardinals are driving here. And Anderson carried it for the first and 10 at the 6-yard line. First and goal at the 6.
I wouldn't change nothing now, Lindsey. You got a hot back, as he has been all year long. Give it to him. 68, Terry Steve.
Steve is coming off, and George Collins is replacing him in the offensive line for the Cardinals. Anderson and Theodis Brown are the setbacks for Steve Pisarkiewicz. Philly moves over. That's Anderson. Touchdown! Anderson in for the touchdown, and the Cardinals are out front.
That's his 6th touchdown rushing on the year at number 8 total. Caught 2 touchdown passes. There he is. Otis Anderson goes in from 6 yards out. Willard Harrell in there coming up, getting a block on the linebacker, and a good one. Check that. That's the Otis Brown, 33. Got a great block. Bob Young around again, but Anderson just high steps it in.
Conversion attempt coming. Worley is holding now for Little. Little's kick. It's no good. It's wide. Wide to the right side, no good. So the score is 13-10.
There it is. It goes wide to the right, hits the goal post, and goes to the right. No good.
Marge? Marge!
In here, dear.
Oh, wait till you hear what I want for Christmas. I saw it at Sears Auto Center today. Their best timing light. On sale for
$29.99. Oh, that's nice, dear.
Right, I could tune up the car, maybe save some gas. Marge?
Yes, dear.
Sears has a battery charger on sale, too. $19.99.
Oh, I could sure use that this winter. You hear me, Marge?
A timing thing and a battery gadget. I hear you, dear.
Sears, where America shops for value.
Another super value from Sears.
We just got this 19-inch Sears color TV on sale for only $399.95.
You save $60, and it's great. You just push a button to change channels.
And it's got electronic tuning.
With no moving parts to wear out.
Automatic light sensor and one-button color.
I love it. For only $399.95, you can just push a button and goodbye, football.
Sears, where America shops for value.
Tonight at 8, 7 Central.
My high school class is naming me Man of the Year.
And the old flames return to Archie Bunker's place.
How's Edith?
Little will kick off for the Cardinals now. From the 35-yard line, Cardinals have a 3-point lead, and we have 2 minutes, 53 seconds left to play in the game.
That's his 6th extra point miss on the year, Steve Little.
James Owens at the 5-yard line. He's at the 10, at the 15, at the 20, at the 25, at the 30. And Owens carries to the 33-yard line. Brought down by Sean Clancy. So the 49ers now have it in their own territory. 2 minutes, 45 seconds on the clock, and they trail by 3.
DeBerg will try to move the football down the field, throwing in, of course, that Cardinal defense. They'll be back in to prevent anything overthrown. It becomes a dangerous situation for San Francisco because of a chance of an interception.
Penalty marker. DeBerg throws. They get a freebie. McAfee across the 50, and he gets down to the 49-yard line. Offsides against the St. Louis Cardinals, which enabled the 49ers to take the play, and a first down in Cardinal territory at the 49-yard line.
Oh, yeah, picked up 17. A little problem with the rest mic.
This is Hofer looking for a corner to turn. gets inside the 45-yard line. Ken Green made the tackle.
Hofer got out of bounds very wisely, too. Lynn's to stop the clock. Fourth quarter, Kansas City easily over Seattle by 30. DeBerg now 10 out of 19 for 121.
Ball is at the 42-yard line, second down, about 3.5. Linville Elliott's in there now for the 49ers. Elliott and Francis are the setbacks. DeBerg. Incomplete. Intended for Francis. He was out of bounds when he gathered it in, so it's an incompletion. Third down. 3.5 at the 42. Bill Walsh along the sidelines. Hofer's carried 16 times for 52 yards today for the 49ers. Big third down play coming now. Cardinals are leading by a score of 13-10. DeBerg. And it's complete for the first and 10 to Brewer. Bob Brewer. It's at the 28-yard line. Ken Green and Ken Stone converge for the tackle for the Cardinals, but the 49ers keep the drive alive.
Yeah, it seems as if they're going to let the clock run down to the two-minute warning. They've got 7 seconds to get it off. Could have hustled, maybe got off a play.
It's down to 202, 201, and now the two-minute warning. Whistle for the automatic timeout. So with 2 minutes remaining to be played in this game in St. Louis, it's the Cardinals 13 and the 49ers 10.
I'm Cheryl Teague. I feel at home in front of the camera. But behind the camera, I don't know the difference between a lens opening and a Broadway opening. So I rely on my Olympus OM-10. My trusty OM-10 gets great shots automatically. My OM-10 has this smart little red light that tells me when it's okay to shoot. Oh, it's okay to shoot. Hold it, fellas! With Olympus OM-10, great shots, automatically.
Ford 79 countdown clearance is underway. Your Ford dealer is receiving allowances and additional cash incentives that he can pass on to you now when you buy selected new 79 Ford cars and trucks. It could add up to $400 on V8 Mustangs and pickups, $600 on LTD, over $1,000 on Heritage Thunderbirds. See your Ford dealer now. Ask him about the $400, $600, and $1,000 better ideas.
We have 2 minutes to play in the ballgame. Bill Walsh, head coach of the San Francisco 49ers, with his team, first down and 10 yards to go at the 28-yard line of the Cardinals, who are coached by Larry Wilson. The 49ers have 2 timeouts remaining, and the Cardinals have 3 timeouts remaining.
Giants of Dallas tied up second quarter. Tell you, the guy who's really anxious on the sidelines is Steve Little. He missed that extra point, hit the goalpost, bounced wide. And boy, he's just sitting on the sidelines, and his stomach is churning right now, if that would be the difference, if they have to kick a field goal here.
First and 10, 49ers at the Cardinal 28. Francis and Hofer are the setbacks to Steve DeBerg. DeBerg. Intercepted at the 15-yard line. Taken by Carl Allen. Carl Allen running it back to the 35. And he gets it to the 39-yard line. And the Cardinals get the football. Steve DeBerg intercepted.
He had all the time to throw the football. They had prevent defense back there. 4-man rush put on by the Cardinals here. Throws it under a little pressure. Watch Carl Allen, number 4 on the year for Allen. Returns it just shy of the 40-yard line. St. Louis football. They'll try to run it out. Hofer on the stop.
49ers have 2 timeouts. Bill Walsh. It's been that kind of a year. One minute, 46 seconds remaining to be played in this game. Cardinals lead by a score 13-10 and ahead of the ball. Theodis Brown and Otis Anderson to the setbacks. Anderson to the 40-yard line. Picked up one. There is Little along the sideline.
This is Revolutionary Flex Track. Now you can make the great race courses. Daytona, Flex Track. Riverside, Flex Track. Long Beach, Flex Track. Banks. Bends. Bumps at lightning fast speeds with AFX G Plus cars, the fastest and most authentic in the world. Flex Track. G Plus race cars, now in new Mario Andretti Grand Prix International race sets. Only from Aurora AFX, the closest thing to real racing.
Anderson has come off the field for the St. Louis Cardinals, holding his left wrist as he came off. Play is resumed. It'll be 2nd and 9 for the Cardinals, and they held the ball at the 40-yard line. 49ers now have one more timeout. They can stop the clock one more time. We have 1:35 left to play in this game, and the Cardinals are leading it by a score of 13-10. If the 49ers lose the ball game, they will have set a new NFL record for consecutive losses on the road. Harold is in there in the backfield now with Theodis Brown. Kosarkiewicz, the Cardinal quarterback. Theodis Brown. Sprints through to the 47. Dan Bunce in to make the tackle. And once again, a timeout, the last time that the 49ers can stop the clock. 1.5 left to play in this game. Our producer today, Mr. David Fox. Our director, Chris Erskine. These are the people who made this telecast possible here this afternoon. St. Louis Cardinals came into this game with a record of 3 wins and 10 losses, coached this afternoon by Larry Wilson, formerly the director of pro personnel. Following this game, the San Francisco Network will see Minnesota at Los Angeles. St. Louis Network will see the New York Giants at Dallas. Ball is marked ready for play.
Well, the Cardinals finish up the home season next week against the New York Giants, and they play the Bears in Chicago, and then the 49ers. For you 49er fans, we'll have something to say about the Central Division race. They play Tampa Bay next week at home. Bears are now only one game behind Tampa Bay.
3rd and 2 for the Cards at their 47. Well, it's just a struggle for Theodis Brown, who took it all the way down to the 36-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Cardinals at the San Francisco 36. A disappointing day for Bill Walsh. A frustrating day.
And that'll be it. They can run out the clock now.
The 49ers cannot stop it. Clock is running with 1:03 remaining. Cardinals are in no hurry whatsoever. San Francisco came to this game with a record of 1 win and 12 losses. The one victory this year was over the Atlanta Falcons in San Francisco.
Theodis Brown, 46 yards, 5 carries.
38 seconds, 37 seconds.
Guess what?
Sarkiewicz hits the deck at the 40-yard line. Now they don't have to do anything. They can simply let it run out if they wish, because 49ers can't stop it, and 20 seconds remain on the clock. So they don't have to do a thing, as it is a 13-10 ball game. The St. Louis Cardinals, in the act of getting their 4th victory of the year, that'll make them 4-10, and San Francisco will be 1-13.
You're looking dead straight in the number one draft pick of the National Football League next year, 49ers.
Larry Wilson leaving the field. Final score, 13-10, the Cardinals win. Lindsey Nelson with Paul Horning. Stay tuned as the NFL Today continues after this word from your local station.
This is CBS.